Hey guys, welcome to the next development log for what we are now calling Archvale. This is a fair bit of new progress since last time. I'm basically going to be showcasing stuff by showing how you might start playing through the game, or how a new player might start playing through the game. It's in the demo form. So there are some loose objectives to the game right now, so like things that you should be aiming to do in order to progress. So obviously you spawn in the forest area, and there are a couple things to do in the forest area. So you've got these shells, which are useful for making armor, so that they're a crafting resource. So priority one is collecting shell to build some armor so that you don't die as much. And priority two right now is finding the town. So the starting biome will have a town in it, and towns will be a recurrent theme throughout the game. There will be multiple towns that you come across, whether they're tiny villages or major parts of a kind of story. So that's what I'll be trying to do, just try to come across the town. Additionally, there are chests, and they can drop some equipment for us, weapons, and so can enemies. Enemies have a rare chance to drop some weapons, so that's the third priority, getting some new equipment. And what this is all leading up to is us being able to obtain stronger resources than shell. So a key goal at the start of the game is to reach the underground, and to get to the underground you'll have to break into a cave, which will require an iron pickaxe, which will require you to get iron, and iron is in the desert. So iron is, the desert is a bit harder to survive in, so you need to try and get yourself some gear before you go there. And a good player could probably just go there straight away. However, you also need to buy a pickaxe from the town shop, so we also need to grind up some money from killing enemies. This is all just kind of a pacing thing to make sure a new player can learn the game in the forest area before they venture out too far, and just ensures there's plenty of stuff to do. Some other changes that you might notice while I'm playing: there's some music in the background, some really nice music done by Goji, who I've been working with for a while now. He's doing some really cool stuff, and I hope he's going to do the whole soundtrack. There's also healing potions now. I can't use it because I haven't taken any damage, but there's also health drops from enemies to help you survive. There's just generally some features to help you live longer. Okay, so we found the town. So you have a bunch of NPCs wandering around, you can talk to them. They don't have much to say right now, as you can see. So we have an inn. The inn is quite barren right now, nothing to do in there. Then we have the shop over here. We can talk to the lady, and she will tell us we can have a browse. What we're wanting to buy is the stone pickaxe, which costs 30, but we only have 20. The buy text should be in red, but it's in yellow right now. They should be red to show we can't afford it just yet. But and finally we have the crafting area. So we have quite a lot of shell, so we can actually make both the armor and the shield. So there's two parts to armor equipment right now. There's the main armor, which will change how your character looks, and there's the sub armor, which will change depending on what kind of stats you're wanting. So ones that improve ranged ability will probably be more like quivers, whereas ones for melee and tanking will be shields. And we'll have a bunch of types for that. So I need to get some more money, since that's all I'm lacking right now. Then we can try to find a desert biome so that we can start harvesting iron. It's quite a lot of items, like the honey, that doesn't have, that don't have uses yet, but those will have uses. Every item will have some kind of use. And hopefully the use won't just be to be sold to NPCs, because that's kind of lame. Even if it's just a more creative thing, rather than just directly selling it. Even if it's just, this item is wanted by this person, or this group of people, or whatever. A question I've been getting asked a lot about this game, we've got the staff, is whether or not this is going to have a story, or what, and we are aiming to have a story that you follow along with, and there's a main quest line, but obviously along with that there's the open world, just do what you want aspect. There is also a quest system in place currently, which isn't fully working, so I'm not going to show you it. However, there will be randomly generated quests that NPCs can give you, and that will be another way to earn money. You may have noticed minimap bugs. This minimap is new, but things that it allows me to draw icons on the map. For objects, like the chests draw themselves on the map to show you if there's a chest in the room or not, but they will draw themselves even if they're not meant to be being drawn, like they're off screen. Like you can see these buildings are drawing themselves off screen, which they shouldn't be doing. Right now, during the night, the shop is still open and it's completely pitch black, which is kind of creepy to be honest, but it's fine. So we've bought a stone pickaxe. Which doesn't look like stone right now, so that should be changed. Okay, so now that we have this, we can try to leave this biome and go to a desert to try and find some iron. And then with the iron, you will be able to craft a bunch more things. The iron will be used for both weapons and armor. Unlike the shell, which is just armor right now. And obviously also be able to make that new pick that will get us into the underground. The underground isn't currently implemented, but, you know, you'll get the gist. So right now, I've manually made it so that the south and east biome to the starting biome are deserts. So I should find a desert below me here. So the desert is, I've stripped a couple of features from it and made it a little bit easier than it was in the last video. But I'm going to be working on making this place a bit more interesting and a bit more lively soon. Because there's not a whole lot of enemies here right now. Just running around the desert, smacking iron to harvest some. And right now that's all you can do in the desert. It's quite lame, and there needs to be more you can do here. But you know, this is just a very loose starting point. So I'm hoping to release a demo to everyone who's interested, publicly for free, for everyone to play. And I'm hoping to update that demo quite regularly with content for you to continue playing. It would be great to have a kind of constant feedback loop of people saying, this item is too strong, this area is too hard, this area needs this, and it would be really useful to get that kind of input on the development. So that is my plan here. This area will have different music at some point. Right now it's just the overworld theme. The forest theme, but you know. Also, the chests here will contain different stuff to just what's contained in the forest chests. Okay, we will probably do a little bit more mining. Maybe I'll try and loop back around through a different biome. Let's see what happens. Sometimes biomes will link together and sometimes they won't. My theory here is that I can go through this biome, which is not our starting biome, and try and get back to our starting biome, a different route, just to kind of show how the world works. I do need to set up an actual biome map to show you all of the biomes you've discovered and stuff, so that you can kind of plot out the world and work out where you are at all times, because exploration will be quite a key part. Something that's not in the game right now, which is the reason for the name of the game, are arches. And arches are going to be two amethyst staffs at once. They're a part of 1 in 100, so that's quite unlikely. So arches are going to be a story mechanic thing, which will basically allow you to kind of fast travel, but in a less boring way. You'll have to reach an arch to be able to teleport between arches, and they basically work like teleport points for you, so you can get around the world quicker. Looks like this biome is not going to lead me home, so probably going to have to go back through the desert. One thing that has changed actually recently is how the dodge roll works. You may have noticed it. But it basically works more how Enter the Gungeons works now. So you have the initial jump of the roll, and then you land on the floor and are vulnerable. So whilst you're in the air, so there to there, you are invincible. But then there's a moment of time where you're rolling along the ground vulnerable. So if you are constantly using it, you're going to be constantly giving yourself vulnerability in a kind of movement locked state, so that for a couple of frames you are locked in movement of whichever direction you jumped in. So there are downsides to jumping now. So you shouldn't spam it, otherwise you will probably take a lot of damage that you don't want to take. It also probably shouldn't rain in a desert, but that's fine. It currently rains indoors in towns, so I can deal with it raining in the desert. Okay, so we will make our way back to the town. Another thing I need to implement is a bigger map for a bigger view of this, so you can see everything you've seen inside the biome. I wonder if I fixed the raining inside bug. That'll be interesting. I may have. I did. Genius. Right, so now with our iron ore we can make iron bars. I only got that much? I didn't realise I got so little. And now we can make iron armour rather than our shell. So I'll make this because it changes how we look, and we look cool now. That's the basic gameplay loop that we have so far. I call it a loop progression, I should say, and this is kind of how the game will continue, with gathering resources in increasingly difficult areas, but obviously it's going to open up a bit, and there's going to be lots of biomes you can be in at once, rather than a linear, you need to go to this one, then this one, then this one. So hopefully this looks interesting in some way. There will be a demo as soon as I can get one available to you. I'm excited to let everyone play. So, thank you very much for watching, and hopefully there will be another devlog soon.